We're going to break it down, baby. I got 14 scriptures to go into. We're going to talk on the conscience. You see what I'm talking about? That conscience got something to do with your salvation. That conscience got something to do with whether you saved or not. That conscience, look, your conscience, amen, is in you. That's your feelings. Amen. And let me say this here. Amen. If you does wrong to God or to man, and your conscience doesn't bother you, you're not saved. We're going to break that down, baby. You see what I'm talking about? I don't understand how these folk not pay their tithes and their conscience don't bother them. I don't understand how they don't take care of the telecast and their conscience don't bother them. I don't understand how they don't take communion and their conscience don't bother them. I don't understand how they miss church and their conscience don't bother them. I don't understand how you could do people's wrong, baby. You know you're full of jealousy. You know you're full of hate. Your conscience don't bother you. You see what I'm talking about? Your conscience should bother you to get it right, baby. Your conscience should bother you to correct that, baby. All right, let's go to the book of Acts. The 24th chapter. And the 16th verse. That's Acts 24 and 16. All right, I want you to read for me, honey.
And herein do I exercise myself to have always the conscience void of offense.
Hold it! I exercise myself to have a conscience void. Go ahead.
And hereby do I exercise myself to have always the conscience void of offense toward God and toward me.
All right. I always exercise myself to have a conscious void toward offense. Word offense means wrong. Toward God and always toward man. You see what I'm talking about? Exercise means I'm going to fight to do what's right. That I would have a clear conscience that I did not do God wrong, nor did I do man wrong. Do you see what I'm talking about? Hey, amen. Paul wanted a conscience void of offense, which is sin toward God and toward man. Now, let me explain something to you, honey. We know we can sin against God, but didn't you know you could sin against man? You see what I'm talking about? When you sin against God, that will bother your conscience if you saved. And when you sin against man, that will bother your conscience also if you are saved. Do you see what I'm talking about? See, your conscience is affected by the wrong you do. Do you see what I'm talking about? If you don't do wrong, your conscience would not be affected. But if you do wrong toward God, toward man, that's going to affect your conscience, baby. Pull it up, baby. Why does it affect your conscience? God allows it to affect your conscience that you will correct the matter. That you will get the thing right, baby. Do you see what I'm talking about? Our conscience affects us because we know we've done wrong toward God. Our conscience affects us. We when we know that we have disobeyed the word of God. You see what I'm talking about? Our conscience affects us because we know we did certain people's wrong or wasn't fair with certain people's. It gotta be corrected, baby. Now hold it up, baby. If your conscience is bothering you and you don't correct that, you're gonna die in your sin. And you can go to hell, baby. Any Christian that I say Holy Ghost feel, the Holy Ghost in them moves their conscience, baby. It bothers their conscience that they'll repent toward God, that they'll correct the matter. Now, if you ignore your conscience, you are ignoring the word of God. If you are ignoring your conscience, you are ignoring God. Do you see what I'm talking about? Since I've been saved, I have saw my conscience being affected. When I did wrong toward God, it bothered my conscience until I repented and corrected the matter, baby. Once I repented and corrected the matter, my conscience went away. It didn't go away until I repented, until I correct the matter. That's the experience I had with me and God. I had another experience with me and man, which means me and my wife. When I done my wife, when I done my wife wrong, if I said something to her that wasn't right, if I behaved in a wrong way toward my wife, that would bother my conscience. But after I go to her and apologize, amen, I'm sorry, honey, forgive me, honey, and repent to God, the conscience go away. Hold it, baby. That's how you know when God done forgave you of the sin, when the conscience go away. Hold it, long as the conscience is there, sin is there. You see what I'm talking about? Your conscience affects you to let you know that something is wrong. Your conscience affects you to let you know that is sin in you. And you need to correct those sins, baby. Let me explain something to you, honey. You won't feel better until you correct the sin. Do you see what I'm talking about? You got to get that thing, whatever that is. You got to get it out of your spiritual system. You see what I'm talking about? Whatever that thing is that you have done toward God or done toward man, if it's in your spiritual system, it's going to sit a conscience off. Hold it. It's going to have you feeling guilty. Yeah, it's going to have you feeling guilty. It's going to have you dodging people. It's going to have you not be able to face them. You can't face them because you're guilty. You see what I'm talking about? You cannot face them because your conscience is bothering you toward them. Do you see what I'm talking about? In order for your conscience to stop bothering you, you gotta correct the matter. Do you see what I'm talking about? If you doesn't clear your conscience, that means the sin or the wrong you did to God or to people stays in you. Do you see what I'm talking about? Here's the question, baby. How does we clear up our conscience? Number one, if your conscience is bothering you with God, let's deal with God first. If your conscience is bothering you with God, number one, you repent to God. You got to repent over the sin. And after you repent over the sin, after that you correct the sin. You see what I'm talking about? That's why the Bible said once the worshipers are purged, they have no more remembrance of sin. It shouldn't bother their conscience no more. Hold it, baby. Let me explain something to you, honey. Look at the sins I committed in the world. It don't bother me now, do it? They are forgiven. But let me go out there now and do the same sin. It'll bother my conscience. You see what I'm talking about? I don't understand. Look, I don't say a lot of things. A lot of these folk I know ain't saved. God, for one thing, they ain't got no conscience. You see what I'm talking about? A lot of these folk I know they ain't saved, baby. In other words, the Holy Ghost not living in them. Because if the Holy Ghost living in you, the Holy Ghost is going to knock on wood. You see what I'm talking about? The Holy Ghost is going to send off a signal. Don't you see what I'm talking about? Paul realized that he had a conscience, but he didn't want his conscience to bother him with God or man. This is why he stated that he strived to live a void of conscience between God and man. Do you see what I'm talking about? If your conscience, number two, if your conscience is bothering you because of the wrong you have done to someone else, your conscience would not go away until you go to that person. Well, prophet, I repent over it. That ain't the way the Bible say do it. That ain't the way that God say do it. God say go to your brother and get that reconciled. You see what I'm talking about? The Bible said if thy remember that thy brother have an ought against thee, or you got one toward him, you go to that brother. Matter of fact, the Bible told you to get up from prayer. It said lay aside the prayer and first go reconcile. That's what the word said. Hold it, baby. The Bible told you to stop praying. If you got something against folks, if you got an ode against a folk, that's the only time the Bible told you not to pray. Hold it. That's another time the Bible told you not to pray if you in sin. Unless you gonna repent. God is holy, baby. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. If your conscience is bothering you because of the wrong you have done to someone, number one, you go to that person and apologize. Hold it up, baby. You got to lay your pride aside. You're not living for you. You're living for Christ. But hold it. When you're living for Christ, you got to lay your feelings aside, baby. Because your feeling can cause you to sin against God. You see what I'm talking about? That's why Paul said for me to live is Christ. He said the life I now live, I live it by the faith of the Son of God that died for me. You see what I'm talking about? You have to lay your feelings aside. Well, I'm in pride. Well, the Bible said pride come before a fall. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. You go and apologize to that person. You correct the situation. Do you see what I'm talking about? Then the conscience will go away. See, what caused our conscience to bother us is what we know of us. You like that?
Yes, I do.
Let me explain something to you, honey. Judas knew what he did.
Yes, he did.
That's why his conscience drove him to hang himself. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Your conscience is affected by what you know you did was wrong. You see what I'm talking about? It's what we know of us, that we know of what we did was wrong. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. That will affect the conscience because you know of you. Hold it. And the Bible says, even a child is known by his ways, whether they're good or evil. A child know if he done done wrong.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does. Yes, yes.
You know if you done done wrong. And if you know that you have done wrong, it would bother your conscience. You cannot serve God with a bad conscience. You got a bad conscience of knowing you did wrong. And you go to pray to God, he will not hear the prayer. That's why the Bible says stop praying and go reconcile first, that God will hear your prayer. He said after you reconcile, then come back to the altar. You cannot pray with a bad conscience. You cannot worship God with a bad conscience. Don't you see what I'm talking about? This is why some peoples you running from. Your conscience is giving you away. You see what I'm talking about? You know you've been talking about them. Amen. You know you're jealous of them. You see what I'm talking about? You can't face them, baby. That conscience in you got you running. Got you that you can't face them, baby. Hold it. You don't cover that mess up, baby. It ain't nothing but sin you covering up. It ain't nothing but filth you covering up, baby. You better get that mess out your system, baby. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. Look at folk that get home or get behind closed doors and talk about folks, gossip about folks. When they see them, they can't face them because they know that they've been talking about them. Like I said earlier, you know what you done did. You see what I'm talking about? They cannot face them. They can't speak to them. They can't fellowship. They running. This is why Adam hid from God, his conscience. You see what I'm talking about? He knew he did wrong. When God told him not to eat that fruit, He knew what he did. He ate it. When he ate it, his conscience bothered him, and he went hid from the presence of God. You see that? That lets you know, baby, when you do wrong, your conscience bothers you. You run from the truth. You hide from the truth. Amen. You hide from people. You run from people. The problem is not the people. The problem is you. Know you see what I'm talking about? Amen. My conscience will give me a way toward you if I have talked about you, if I'm jealous of you, or if I have done evil toward you. Amen. That is in my system. Amen. And it's bothering my conscience. Amen. To ease my conscience, I can't face you. Hold it. Instead of you correcting that, so you can get rid of your bad conscience, so you can face the person, so you can communicate with the person, you'd rather keep that bad conscience and keep hiding from them. That ain't good, baby. You see what I'm talking about? That's why, baby, I don't talk about nobody. I don't want my conscience to affect me. That's why there's not nobody I'm jealous of, never have been jealous of. I don't want my conscience to affect me, baby. Amen. I won't have a clear conscience toward God and man, baby. That's what I'm talking about. You see what I'm talking about? And what caused these four walk up to you when they do see you? God bless you, sister.
Looking over the word. I've had that though.
You see what I'm talking about? That's what caused these people, amen, when they see you, hey, look, did you see that? That ain't good, baby. That stuff will carry you to hell, baby. That stuff is in you. You better get that out your system, baby. That's what I'm talking about, baby. Because the Bible tells us that God can judge the deep things of man, baby.
Now, that's the word. That's the word, teacher. You right about it. Yes, we are.
Now, I'm not saying we don't sin. We sin against God. We sin against man. But when we do sin against God, when we do sin against man, do we correct it? Do we repent it? Amen. Do we correct the matter? Hold it up, baby. Let me explain something to you here. I'm not going to call myself a Christian and be feeling like a sinner. You want me to break that down? I'll break it down. All right, I'm calling myself a Christian, but I'm feeling like a sinner. Let's go back when you was a sinner. When you was a sinner, you talked about folk. Did that bother your conscience? No. When you went out there and commit adultery, baby, did that bother your conscience? When you drunk alcohol, got sloppy drunk, did that bother your conscience? That's living like a sinner, baby. I'm not going to get saved and live like a sinner that it don't bother my conscience, baby. That's what I'm saying, baby. You got a lot of folks, baby, that's saying they are saved. Huh? Amen. But they living, their feelings are living like a sinner.
All right, you're right. You're right.
Don't nothing affect them. Don't nothing bother them.
If anything, you're right about it.
You don't have no conscience of correct that. You don't have no conscience of getting it right. Prophet, I'm in the church under your ministry, and I don't have no conscience like that. You need to get out the building, baby. Get in the body. You need the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost, give you that
Holy Ghost, give you that conscience, baby.
Yes, he does. Yes, yes.
That's what calls us to live holy, the conscience.
All right, now, Brigham.
That's what calls us to do right, the conscience. That's what calls us to do right toward peoples, the conscience, baby. I don't want to get up here and preach while I'm preaching. My conscience bothering me while I'm preaching. Your conscience will make you feel like a hypocrite. You see what I'm talking about? I doesn't want to go in prayer while I'm praying to God. My conscience is bothering me that I done God wrong or I done someone else wrong. I don't want to sit up under the word. And the word go forth, baby. And it convict me. It's not the word convicting you. Your conscience convicting you. Hold it, baby. The word don't convict nobody. The word saves a man. The word heals a man. He sent his word and healed them. The word don't convict nobody. It's your conscience that convicts you, baby. It's that mess that's in you that convicts you. It's the sin that's in you convicts you, baby. That's what I'm talking about. You see that?
That is so loud. You teach it good now. That's the truth, though. Yeah.
How in the hell the word convict you when the word say Peter? The word say Paul? The word say the early church? The word say Zacchaeus. The word say Nicodemus. The word say Prophet Townsend. The word don't convict, it say. Your conscience convicts you. That's why these folk can't sit under holy teaching. They got a bad conscience, baby. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. Your conscience can give you away. When you committed sin and you hear the truth of God's word. If you commit sin and hear the truth of God's word. Amen. Your conscience can give you away. In other words, if you committed sin and you've been ignoring your sin, hiding your sin, and the word preach on it, that would agitate your conscience. But hold it up, baby. It will agitate your conscience to repentance. It would agitate your conscience as guilt. You guilty in what you feel guilty in what you done did. Don't you see what I'm talking about? I mean, it's people consciences have them not to face the truth. People conscious have them running from the truth. Let me explain something to you, honey. These wrong spirits in you gives you a bad conscience. The spirit of lust in you, if you committed it, can give you a bad conscience toward God. The spirit of hate, the spirit of jealousy in you can give you a bad conscience toward God and the person that you're jealous of. This is why I'm purposing my conscience is void of God. Void of man. Let me explain something to you, honey. It's not that I've been living above sin. No, I have sinned it. But I have repented over those sins. Correct the matter. Therefore, I can face God in prayer. I can face God in his word. I mean, the Spirit of God can preach on anything. Spirit of God can preach on love, preach on homosexual, preach on adultery, whatever. Tithes, over it, telecast. My conscience is void. I can face God's word with that. I don't care what the pastor's preaching on. My conscience can face it, baby. Because my conscience is void toward God and man. That's what I want you to know. You see what I'm talking about? Hold it up, baby. This is why I can face you. I can face you. I can face you. I can face you. I can face you too. I can face you. I can face you. Because my conscience is void. I don't have no lust toward nobody. I hadn't been talking against nobody. I'm not jealous of nobody. My conscience is void. Therefore, I could fellowship with you. Therefore, I could face you. I could speak to you and look you dead in the eyes. That's what I'm talking about. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. The spirit of lust, if you committed it. Amen. Hate. All of these things can give us a bad conscience. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. You cannot ignore your conscience. What is conscience? Conscience is a spiritual pain. You shoot them, it's conviction. It's guilt. May I go on? Yeah. You shoot what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do, my teacher.
It's guilt.
Yeah, that's all.
That's all conscience is. It's guilt. It's guilt because you know it was wrong. Now, if you know it was wrong, you got to correct it. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. This is why that we want to have a good conscience toward God and toward man. If you want us to have a good conscience toward God, do right toward God. Obey the word. Correct the matter. If you want to have a good conscience toward peoples, don't talk about peoples. Don't be jealous of them. Don't hate them. Don't do them wrong. I don't want to live and got to dodge peoples. That's too low for me. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. I don't want to have no bad conscience that I done talked about you or I done lied on you. Amen. Or I got bad feelings toward you. I'm not going to stoop that low, baby.
No, I'm not. I'm valuing myself more than you.
Because when my conscience is bothering me, it's telling me I'm not qualified to pray. You stop back praying when your conscience stop bothering you. But in order for your conscience to stop bothering you, you got to correct the matter, baby. You got to repent over the situation, baby. Now you can try to hide your feelings toward people, but you cannot hide your conscience from you. Oh, yeah. You see what I'm talking about? You can hide your feelings toward people. You can hide your lust toward people that you lust toward them. You can hide your jealousy toward them, but you can't hide your conscience from them. From you. You see what I'm talking about? But hold it up, baby. This is how I know I'm saved. This is how I know I'm right in God.
Go ahead.
This is how I know I'm living holy.
Go ahead, teacher.
When anything bothers my conscience, immediately I correct it. Immediately I'm going to repent over it. I'm not going to allow it to stay in me and bother me. Do you see what I'm talking about? All right, let's go to St. Matthew's 27:3. Let's deal with Judas and how his conscience affected him and what his conscience drove him to do. The same way a man's conscience can drive him to commit suicide, a man's conscience can drive him away from holy teaching. The same way a man's conscience can drive him into suicide, the same way a man's conscience can drive him away from dodging you.
All right, that's true, teacher. You got a Bible.
Read that for me, honey. St. Matthew 27:3.
Then Judas, which had betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself and brought again the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priest.
All right, let me tell you what happened here with Judas. Judas' conscience affected him because he knew he did Jesus wrong. Hold it. Like I said earlier, baby. Amen. You know what's in you. You know what you did. You know how you feel.
Go ahead, teacher. You're right.
He knew what he did.
He did.
He knew that he was the one that betrayed Christ. He knew he was the devil.
He did that. Go ahead now.
And he knew what he did.
All right, you're right.
He betrayed innocent blood.
Yes, he did.
The holy. This what brings the. This what brings this conscience. When we know we done betrayed innocent blood. In other words, when we know we done talked against someone that was holy. When we know we done talked against someone that was saved. When we know we have did wrong to someone that didn't do wrong to us. You see what I'm talking about? Judas knew. And I'm going to go with Saul too. Oh, I got a lot of them I'm going to. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Show you how the conscience affects you. Amen. And show you how the conscience can drive you. There's a lot of people, they allowing their conscience to drive them. You see what I'm talking about? It's a reason why you can't speak to certain folks. Your conscience is driving you. There's a reason why you can't face the truth, because your conscience is driving you. Do you see what I'm talking about? We will show you this in the Word of God, how certain people's conscience drove them. That's why I need to get rid of it if it's bothering you. And the only way that their conscience gonna go away, you gotta correct the situation and repent over it. Do you see what I'm talking about? All right, read for me, honey.
Judas, which had betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself and brought again the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priest and elders.
All right, his conviction, his conscience, what led him to bring back the 30 pieces of silver that they had given him. This is what happened. First of all, before he turned Christ in and did wrong, he didn't have no conscience. You don't get the conscience before the sin. You get the conscience after the sin. You don't get the conscience before you do wrong. You get the conscience after you do wrong. All right, now you look at Judas here. before he did wrong, yes, before he turned Christ in to the chief priest, he didn't have no conscience because he hadn't done the wrong. Yes. But after he had turned Christ in, yes, and they convicted Christ to death, yes, after he committed the sin, yes, look what the scripture is saying here. It bothered his conscience, and by it bothering Judas' conscience, that drove his conscience, drove him to give the money back. Yes, 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 yes. But after he was willing, after his conscience started bothering him, and he gave the money back, the devil didn't want it. You see how deceitful the devil is? The devil didn't want the money back. Judas' conscience kept bothering him. They didn't take the money back. Now they're getting ready to kill Christ. And I'm the causing of it. I'm portraying innocent blood. His conscience went to the second level. It started driving him to suicide. That's what I told you all earlier. Your conscience can drive you. Look at the peoples out there that commit murder. Why do you think they turn themselves in to the police? Their conscience bothers them until it drives them to the police. Do you see what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
That one letter word, conscience, clean up the whole church.
All right, say it now.
You see what I'm talking about? Judas knew he was the one that turned Christ over. Judas knew he was the one that betrayed innocent blood. And after he had did it, his conscience started bothering him. Your conscience don't bother you before you talk about peoples. It bothers you after you talk about peoples. Your conscience doesn't bother you before you speak to peoples. It bothers you after you don't speak to them and you ignore them. Your conscience don't bother you before you get in lust. It bothers you after you get in lust. And I got to tell a certain, but wait a minute, sisters, don't keep turning your head and giving yourself away. Because I'm a prophet, I read spirits now. Don't tell me, prophet, I'm not in lust. Baby, you said that with your mouth, but I'm reading your spirit. You see what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
You probably can't face me because of your conscience.
All right now.
I know I shouldn't be like this toward the men of God, but I am. But the reality, can nobody see in you to know whether you are or not.
All right.
But your conscience will give you away. And when your conscience give you away, I will pick up your spirit. Because there's a spirit that comes with the bad conscience.
Say that now. Break it down, teacher.
Break it down.
Break it down. You good now. You good. I know you're right.
And a man that's spiritual minded can pick up that bad spirit. Look, I have targeted 5 women in this church that's in lust. And I picked it up through their spirit. I don't care what they say.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
You see what I'm talking about? Amen. You can try to pull your dress down all you want. I look at it like this. If you're trying to pull it down, why did you wear it short? I mean, if you standing in front of me doing this,
okay.
Why didn't you wear a smock anyway?
All right, yeah.
You should have wore a smock. But if you could look at that, when people stand in front of you and do this, that's guilt toward their body. That's guilt. And when they pull the dress down, that's guilt because they know within themselves it's short. Going back to what I said earlier, guilt comes when you know of you. They know the dress is short, baby. And that when they come around a holy man, they guilty. They feel guilty while they try to pull it down. That's why they're doing this. Well, y'all don't think I pay attention to everything, do you? Uh-huh. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Look. I'm going to put it like this. When I was dating somebody young, and they used to come see me, and they would wear sweaters, and then they would talk with me. And I had to tell her, wait a minute, baby. I said, be proud of... I said, be proud of yourself. Get rid of the guilt. Yeah, see what I'm talking about. I said, that's nothing but.
Yes. Amen.
You don't, look. You hide, I mean, you date me.
Yeah.
You know, you okay. Ain't nothing wrong.
Right.
You are normal.
Right.
That's what I told her, you normal.
Right,
it's not out of the ordinary, it's normal.
Right.
You see what I'm talking? Amen. But I mean, you could see guilt can affect a man in many ways. It can affect guilt can affect you by the way you wear your clothes. If you feel your clothes too low, you go. Guilt affect you if your breath smelling. Did you get back on the shoot? Co-pastor, did you, do you know what evangelist at? Co-pastor did, that's guilt.
That's you, teacher.
You see what I'm talking about? I'm breaking that down to show you and give you understanding of guilt.
Go ahead, teacher.
Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. Guilt affects a person in a man. It affects his feelings. No, you see what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah.
Guilt can make you paranoid.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Well, you know it's paranoid. It may not be stinking, but they think it is. Do you know what? That is guilt, but it may not be.
All right. Go ahead, teacher. That's true.
You see what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
All right, read for me, honey.
Then Judas, which had betrayed him, when he saw that he was condemned, repented himself and brought him 30 pieces of silver to the chief priest and elders, saying, I have sinned in that I have betrayed the
Israelites. Hold it. All right. His conscience bothered him. He stated to the chief priest, he said, I have sinned it. I betrayed innocent blood. That's what was bothering him on the inside. That he had sinned it against God. And that he had betrayed innocent blood. That was bothering him. Guess what, baby? He told the devil that. Think the devil care because your conscience bother you? You think the devil care because Judas' conscience bother him? Don't you see what I'm talking about? The devil didn't care. All right, read that for me, honey. Wait a minute. He said, I have sinned it. What in the hell sinners care about you seeing it? What in the hell unbelievers care about you seeing it? But his conscience will bother him so bad, he had to tell somebody. Why couldn't he tell Christ? He couldn't face Christ.
That's it,
because he knew he'd done Christ wrong.
All right, go ahead.
Why can't he go to Christ's apostle? Because he couldn't face his Christ's apostles neither.
Yeah, you're right about it.
Because he knew he had done Christ wrong.
All right, say it now.
The only one that he was able to face was sinners.
Yeah.
But he had to tell somebody.
Yeah.
You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Look. He couldn't tell Christ. I mean, look, if you've been talking about me, you're not going to tell me you've been talking about me. But you'll confess to other folks. You wouldn't tell me what problem. I'm in lust toward you, but you'll tell the truth to somebody else. If they, so tell the truth now. Come on, between me and you. Well, yeah, you know, a little, some. Yeah, I have. But yeah. But you won't tell me. You're swept down. It's not you. Probably God know my heart. I wouldn't do that to a man of God. Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. Baby, I mean, they'll come to me. Prophet, what? Not a man of God. Prophet, you know I'm not like that. Prophet, I fear God. Prophet, what, you think I'm not saved? No way I would lust after the man of God. No way I would love after somebody that's giving me the word of God. No way. Prophet, no way. Now, you know me better than that. But you get another sister that's weaker than you or on your level or lust like you are. Then you would confess it. Well, you know what, sister? I can't lie. I can't lie. Yeah, I am. But wait a minute, baby. You lied to me.
Show me.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
I feel just like him. I know what you're saying, teacher. Yeah. It's true. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
You see what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
And this is why Judas acted the way that he acted. Let me tell you why God forgave me, delivered me, used me. It's not that I never sinned. I sinned it. Honest with God. Honesty. This is why I live void of offense toward God and toward man. I don't need to talk behind nobody back. Baby, I'll correct you in front of your face. I'm not scared of you. Well, I got to talk behind your back. I'm not scared of you. People that talk behind other folk back are scary cats. They can't face them to the face. I'm not afraid of you. afraid of nobody. I would look, I'd correct you to your face. If I got something to say, I'd say it in front of your face. I'm not scared of you. You're not going to touch me. You're not, I don't care how you feel once I correct you. So what? Now look, I confess man's. Now I didn't get with somebody that was in lust and confess to them with no. I mean, yes, I am. I confess man in the presence of God. Then hold it. Then y'all hear me. I said in the presence of God, I'm not in lust toward not one woman, but my wife. Why should I be in lust? There's no one to fit in co-pastor's shoes. To a one man is all we have been.
Yeah.
See that?
Yes.
All right, ease up. You're in the pulpit. Yeah, on holy ground, baby. You gotta. You can't bring lust on holy ground. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. But I'm proud of my wife when she speak of me out in the public. Say, yes, I love my husband. I'm proud of my husband. I got something good. Every woman want a good man. I got him. You see what I'm talking about? Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. Not only never had a bad conscience toward peoples, yes, sir. I never had a bad conscience toward you.
No.
I only had a bad conscience when I said wrong things to you and you got affected.
Okay.
Now, I correct the situation as the Bible told me to do through God's word. Corrected with co-pastor and repented to God. I didn't have to ban no devils.
No.
I didn't have to ban my conscience.
No.
Amen. It went away on its own.
All right. That's true.
See, a bad conscience is something you don't have to pray to move it.
All right.
If you do what's right, it will go away on its own.
That's true, Father.
I mean, look. You take for instance here, if you hadn't paid your tithes. If you hadn't paid your tithes or you ain't paid it right, that bad conscience gonna stay in you. I don't care how much you rebuke it, plead the blood, it ain't going nowhere. The minute you pay them tithes right, and the minute you pay it, the conscience will go away on its own anyway. Yeah, it'll leave on its own. You see what I'm talking about? All right, let's read, honey. Yes.
Saying I have sinned in that I have betrayed the innocent blood, and they said, what is that to us? See thou to them.
Well, but that sounds like the devil talk.
It does.
I mean, look, you go to the devil, confess to the devil, you done wrong, and you betrayed innocent blood. The devil say, so what? Well, that's to us.
All right.
In other words, how in hell you going to bring it to me? I had you to do it.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. Come on, Judas. You should have known better than that. Man, did all this casting demons out, raising the dead, didn't have no spiritual knowledge. All right, read for me, honey.
And he cast down the pieces of silver in the temple.
Well, his conscience was bothering him. This is why he cast down the pieces of silver in the temple.
Yeah.
Now, let me explain something to you. If Judas' conscience didn't bother him, he would have betrayed the innocent blood and kept the money. Do you think prostitutes, after they do the trick, that they take their money and throw it away? No. No, anything to get happy. They be smiling. You see what I'm talking about? All right, read for me, honey. Holy, holy, baby. You ask me how I know. Baby, look, I've been around almost 50, almost 60 years. Probably you done met prostitutes, a lot of them. They mean I went to bed with them.
Amen.
When I was in the world. A lot of them was in the lounge. I mean, look, some of you all probably was prostitutes in the world and you was in the lounge. But wait a minute now. I'm trying to be good with this now. Prostitute is what sell and get money. Whores give it away. But I always thought in the world that prostitute was smarter than whores. Believe me. You thought that? What's wrong, D? Well, wait a minute, sister. You got to ease down.
I ease up.
All right. Because, see, you know, I move quick with this thing here. Now,
I know you
can. All right. We don't want to give up that old lifestyle. We're going to move on to perfection. You see what I'm talking about? All right, read for me, honey. All right, I have sinned it, and I have portrayed innocent blood.
Yes.
Now, let's go back to that message I preached on the telecast. When these young men get out there and commit murder, or etc., and they go before the judge and say, I done changed my life, I'm saved, I'm in church, the judge still gonna give him time. It's the same with the devil. I done betrayed innocent blood. So what? But in reality, it was Judas' conscience that was bothering him so bad. He had to tell somebody. He did. He told it to the devil. And the devil gave him his response. What's that to us? We don't care. We got our man. And fool you, we use you to do it. And his conscience kept bothering him until it drove him to the next level. The devil went from the chief priest to his man. The same one that said, what that to us, was the same one that told him, kill yourself. The devil have no mercy for man. Only God does. Remember that. That's why you need God, baby. The devil have no mercy for man. Only God have mercy for man. Read.
Saying, I have sinned in it that I have betrayed the innocent blood. And they said, what is that to us? See thou to that.
Go ahead.
And he cast down the pieces of silver in the temple and departed and went and hanged himself.
Now you see what he did? Yeah. You see what your conscience could do? Your conscience can drive you. And that's what it did to Judas. It drove him in two ways. Drove him to the chief priest. Figured he'd get some kind of relief. Or figured they would change their mind. No, not with the devil. And when that didn't work, went to the next level. And it drove himself to hang himself. See what guilt can do. This is why here I'm telling you to be void of conscience toward God and toward man. You cannot get a deliverance through your prayer with a bad conscience. You cannot get in the spirit of God with a bad conscience. You cannot fill the Holy Ghost with a bad conscience. I mean, look, the bad conscience, I mean, when we was a sinner, that conscience gone. Those sins are forgiven. The bad conscience come after you get saved and you do wrong after you get saved, or do other people's wrong after you get saved. You see what I'm talking about? Number one, if you love God, you ain't gonna do God wrong. Number two, if you love your brethren, you're not gonna do him wrong. The Bible said love covers a multitude of sin. That's what the word said. You see what I'm talking about? Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. Your conscience is affected by your feelings. Let's go to Peter. St. Matthew's 26:73. St. Matthew's 26:73. All right, I want you to read that for me, honey.
And after a while, then to him, they that stood by, and said to Peter, surely thou also art one of them, for thy speech bewildereth thee. Then began he to curse and to swear, saying, I know not the man, and immediately...
Hold it! His conscience wasn't bothering him at first.
No.
Till he said, I didn't know the man.
All right.
He denied Christ.
Yes, he did.
Some he shouldn't have did, but he denied him out of fear. And after he denied Christ, that affected his conscience, he wept.
Yeah.
When you wept or you weep, that means you got an inner hurt on the inside.
All right, that's true.
That's why I said your conscience got something to do with your inner feelings.
All right, it does. And it does.
You see what I'm talking about? Yeah. Nobody have to tell you you done wrong. If you's a Christian, number one, the word tell you you done wrong. Number two, you know what you know of you. You done done wrong.
All right, that's
number three, your conscience gonna go off on you and let you know you done wrong.
All right, well said now, well said.
Once you correct one, that's repent and correct it, it clear up all the rest of the three. Don't you see what I'm talking about? All right, read for me, honey.
And after a while, then to him, they that stood by, and said to Peter, surely thou also art one of them, for thy speech bewildereth thee. Then began he to curse and to swear, saying, I know not the man, and immediately the cock crowed.
And Peter remembered the words of Jesus, which said unto him, before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice. And he went out and wept bitterly.
Hold it. He went out and wept. Bitterly. His conscience bothered him. Do you see what I'm talking about? Now here's the problem here, baby. After the cock crowed three times, Jesus turned around and looked at Peter. Peter's conscience bothered him. He dropped his head. That's why I told y'all, I get this from the word of God. When your conscience bothers you, certain folks you can't face. When you know you done them wrong. When you know you got something against them. When you know you done them wrong.
Go ahead now.
You can't face them.
No. Go ahead. All right.
Jesus was right there.
Yeah.
Peter denied that he knew Christ. Yeah. When Christ turned around, he dropped his head. Well.
Yeah.
Couldn't face the man. He was hurt.
Yes, he was, teacher. Yeah. You teach it good now.
Know you see what I'm talking about. This is why he wept. Do you see what I'm talking about? All right, let's go to the Pharisees. And this is why when Jesus wrote on the ground, the country was affected by what Jesus wrote. They couldn't face what he wrote. People's conscience bothered them. They can't face the truth. That's why they walk away. The scripture right there backs me up, baby.
That's true.
You see what I'm talking about? Let's go to St. John 8:9. That's St. John 8 and 9. Read. St. John 8 and 9. St. John 8, 9.
And they which heard it began being convicted by their own conscience.
Hold it. Now, let me break this down.
Yes, sir.
What happened here, first they was accusing this woman of adultery.
Yes.
They had no conscience.
Yes,
who I'm talking about. Because they didn't see themselves. But when Jesus got on the ground and started writing, when they looked at what Jesus wrote, it convicted their conscience. They walked away. This is why so many people, they see the truth, they hear the truth, it bothers their conscience, and they have to walk away from the truth. All right. Number one. Why is it here that after Jesus wrote on the ground, why didn't the Pharisees, instead of them walk away, why didn't they correct the matter? That's a good question. Why is it here that after Jesus wrote on the ground, didn't the Pharisees repent?
Yes.
Instead of them repenting, they walked away. That's with a lot of folks. Once you hear the truth, once you hear what the Spirit is saying, why don't you correct the matter? Why don't you repent over the situation? Why would you want to walk away from the truth? Why would you want to walk away from the Word of God instead of you correcting the matter? This is what God can see in judgment of a person that walked away from the truth. God would want to know, why didn't you correct the matter? But instead you walked away. Why didn't you repent over it and correct it? But instead, you walked away. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. There's a lot of things that God have said in His Word. Amen. That I knew. Some things I was weak, I failed to. But instead of me walking away from the truth, I repented. I correct the situation, baby. You see what I'm talking about? Now, I live before God.
Yes, Lord.
And before man, void of a conscience. This is why I can comprehend with all men. This is why I can face God in prayer. This is why I can face God through holy teaching. This is why I can face God through the truth. I have a clear conscience with God. This is why that I can fellowship with any man. I have a clear conscience with you. I ain't done no one wrong. I don't hate nobody. I'm not in lust toward nobody. I didn't sin against nobody. My conscience are clear toward all men. That's what I'm talking about, baby. You see that? Number one here, what makes a man have a clear conscience is honesty. You got to be honest with yourself. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Baby, you hiding up what's in you is not being honest with yourself. Not only is not honest with God, it's not honest with you. Hold it, baby. Before you become honest with God, you got to first become honest with yourself. That's what I'm talking about. You see that?
Go ahead, teacher.
The reason why many people is not honest with God.
Yeah.
because they're not honest with themselves.
I believe that. Go ahead now.
You see what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
Look at the difference between Saul and David. When the prophet came to Saul, when the prophet came to David, David was honest with himself. He was honest with God. He said, I have sinned, and have mercy upon me, O God.
Now, you're right. Go ahead now.
Look at Saul. When Saul sinned it, he didn't say, have mercy upon me with God. He asked for his javelin to kill David, to move David out the way. This is why I'm telling you, baby, you got to be honest with yourself. Don't you see what I'm talking about? When you are honest with yourself, you will not have no bad conscience. If you honest with yourself, you will not have a bad conscience toward God nor toward man. Let me explain something to you, honey. The mouth can say anything. It's how the conscience feels. The same way a man's heart don't lie. If you do wrong and your conscience affect you, that's not lying on you. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Well, you know, probably I went to this church and that pastor was talking about me. Well, when you got affected by your conscience and your conscience convicted you, who was talking about you then? And it's not, look, what your conscience does. Your conscience goes off to affect you for you to repent and to correct the matter. Hold it, baby. Now, if you look at Judas did wrong, committed and hung himself. David did wrong, committed adultery, and also committed murder. And why is it he didn't hang himself? He repented. And his conscience went away. Prophet, the Bible said Judas repented. The word repented with Judas is not say he repented to God the way you think. The word repented with Judas, he got sorry what he did because what he did was wrong. Because I looked at it like this, baby. If he repented, why didn't he go to Christ? Christ was standing there. Christ, hold it, baby. Christ was standing right there when he gave him away.
Yes, he was. Yeah.
Why couldn't Judas go to Christ even though they had Christ bound? He could have talked to Christ while they had him bound. The thief talked to him while he was on the cross. You see what I'm talking about? And while Jesus was on the cross and the thief talking to Christ, Christ still communicated while he was dying. So if Judas would have repented and told Christ, forgive me, I betrayed innocent blood, I'm sorry, even though they had Christ handcuffed. Christ still could have said, your sins are forgiven while he was here. To be honest with you, baby, Christ was handcuffed on the cross when he said, this day you'll be in paradise. Had his hand nailed to the cross. You see what I'm talking about? That's what I'm talking about, baby. Explain something to you, honey. In order for a man to repent, correct the situation, do right have to be in him. And if you got the Spirit of Christ in you, do right is going to be in you. know you see what I'm talking about. Look, my country will go off on the smallest of things. Let me explain something to you all. I woke up at 6 o'clock this morning. I woke up at 6 a.m. Now, when I woke up at 6 a.m., I decided right then to go in the message that we got tonight. Amen. Then there was another of me, you know, wanted to go into prayer. When I decided to go into the message, it bothered my conscience. Even though it was going into the word, the message. But when I decided to go into prayer first, the conscience went away. That way I knew that God wanted me to pray before I go into the message. So after I prayed, I went into the message. This is why I pay attention to my conscience. You see what I'm talking about? This is what you got to do. You have to pay attention to your conscience. Do you see what I'm talking about? Amen. Your conscience will talk to you spiritually and let you know the way of God. But you got to be spiritual, man. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. Now, look, like I said earlier, there was time. Now, I've been married for almost 40 years.
Yes.
Now, even being saved, there was things that I felt as though that I said harsh words to my wife, and it bothered my conscience that you didn't talk to her right. You hurt her feelings. Now, I didn't ask her did I hurt her feelings. I knew it because it bothered my conscience. In other words, I was hurt behind the way that I communicated with her. And once I realized my conscience was affected, I knew how to get rid of it. I went to her, my wife. I'm sorry. Forgive me. And repented to God, it went away on its own.
All right.
Okay. Look. Yeah. That's sensitive to the Spirit of God. There was things here that I have probably, you know, did wrong to you or someone. I feel as though that, okay, I found this. So, and it bothered my conscience that I said it like this. So I called you in the office and I apologized. And told you I'm sorry. Once I did that, the conscience left. You see what I'm talking about? Amen. But far as talking about people's lusting after them, jealous of them, that never affected me. They never went off on my conscience.
Amen.
You see what I'm talking about? There's nobody I'm jealous of. I got Christ. I don't need one. Look, when you got Christ, anybody should be jealous of? No way. You got Christ. You see what I'm talking about? I mean, if you got Christ, who got more than you? You see what I'm talking about? But see, you got people, they walking around and they are living with these bad conscience in them of knowing that they have sinned it against God, knowing that they have walked away from the truth, knowing that they have done someone wrong. They got the bad conscience in them, knowing they've done them wrong because they were jealous of them. Knowing that they was in lust and they flirt with them.
Right. Go ahead, teacher.
And now their bad conscience in them got them not facing them. Like I said earlier, what caused Adam to hide from God after he sinned it? His conscience. His conscience was bothering him that he had sinned it against God and that he had done wrong. This is why I've told this many a time, and I tell you again tonight. If I die tonight, I die in peace. I have a clear conscience with God and a clear conscience with man. If I die next year, it will still be the same because I'm rooted in Christ. If I die 10 years from now, I will still have a clear conscience with God and with man. Remember one thing, I know how to live safe. Pull it, baby. Just like a sinner know how to live in sin, I know how to live holy.
Say it, all right.
You see what I'm talking about? This is what caused many people afraid to die. They are conscious. You see what I'm talking about? I mean, look, many people, you know, got a lot of folks that say they saved, and you really ask them, if you die tonight, you wouldn't fear. I mean, a lot of them, oh, no, I'm ready to die. Hey, I won't fear death. Amen. Well, with my soul. Well, the same way that Peter said, I won't deny him. You can say anything with your mouth. But when you get through talking, I don't fear death. I know I'm saved. When you really face death, your conscience is going to kick out if there's wrong in you. In other words, no, I'm not ready to die because I know I'm not living holy. Well, that's what I'm saying.
Go ahead.
Do you see what I'm talking about? Look, this is why, like I was preaching over at Jordan Friday. This is why I'm telling you all, I'm resting in God. There's nothing disturbing me. See, your conscience could disturb you. This will cause people not to sleep at night. You have a man that done killed somebody, raped somebody. He can't sleep at night because he know he done murdered somebody. He's tortured. He tormented up all night because it's on his conscience.
Yes.
That's why he's jumping in his sleep and hollering in his sleep. Conscience bothering him. Look, let me explain something to you all. This is why. When I go to sleep at night, I sleep in peace. I sleep good. I'm not up all night. I don't wake up all through the night. I have a clear conscience. There's nothing bothering me that I've done anyone wrong. There's nothing bothering me that I've sinned against God and done God wrong or failed God. There's nothing bothering me that I've done wrong and didn't repent over it and correct the matter. Yeah. I have a clear conscience knowing I done preached the truth on the TV. I done preached the truth in this church. That's give me a clear conscience of knowing I'm doing God's will. Now, if I wasn't doing God's will, and if I knew to do right and didn't do it, or if I knew to preach holiness and didn't preach it, or if I knew to preach what God gave me to preach and I preached something else that would bother my conscience. If I knew the word of God and knew what God told me in his word, and not to do this, not to do that, not to gossip, not to lie, etc. and I knew I have, didn't repent over it, didn't correct it, it would bother my conscience. When I go to pray, I would feel as though I can't get a prayer through. Because my conscience will affect me of bringing back to my attention, look, you're not obeying the word of God. You have failed the word of God. You have sinned it against God. That will be on my conscience. Therefore, God would not hear your prayer. Once a man feels as though that God would not hear his prayer because of his conscience, he would not pray effectively. He would not spend long time in prayer. He would not pray under the anointing. When I pray for over an hour. I feel good in prayer. The Holy Ghost, the anointing hits me all through my prayer. I got up this morning, like I told you, at 6 o'clock and prayed. I mean, a surge of God's anointing all around me. Amen. And perhaps in the middle of the prayer, the power of the anointing hit me. Start speaking in tongues. I know what's going on. I feel good. If I had a bad conscience, it wouldn't happen. If I had a bad conscience of being jealous toward you, it wouldn't happen. If I had a bad conscience of been talking about you, it wouldn't happen. If I had a bad conscience of sinning against God, it wouldn't happen. If I had a bad conscience and you said anything wrong to my wife, it wouldn't have happened. Let me explain something to you. If I rebuke you or anybody, and if I don't come back and repent, the word of God got me backed up and I was right. Amen. We hold it. We live by the word. Jesus Christ rebuked Peter. Did he repent? Jesus Christ rebuked James and John. After Jesus rebuked James and John, did Jesus repent? No. He knew he was right. All right, God bless you.